हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अचीव आईएएस। सो स्वागत है आपका हमारे चैनल पे। सो फ्रेंड्स, एज यू नो दैट ऑन आवर चैनल वी आर कवरिंग द सिलेबस ऑफ यूपीएससी सिविल सर्विसेज, एंड फॉर दैट पर्पस वी हैव स्टार्टेड मल्टीपल सीरीज ऑन आवर चैनल दैट टारगेट योर प्रीलिम्स एज वेल एज मेंस। सो फ्रेंड्स, हियर ऑन आवर चैनल वी ऑल्सो हैव अ डेडिकेटेड सीरीज दैट टारगेट योर प्रीलिम्स। सो वी इन दिस सीरीज वी आर कवरिंग योर 27 फुल लेंथ टेस्ट विच इंक्लूड 18 स्टैटिक टेस्ट एंड 9 करंट अफेयर टेस्ट। So this is test number 3 of our that series that we have started for the prelims of UPSC CSE 2019. So the test number 3 is of current affairs. So let's see what are the questions of test number 3. So here we will explain only the questions. The solutions will be provided separately to the students who will subscribe to our test series. So first question is, consider the following statements. First, the 2018 edition of World Hindi Conference held in Maldives. Second, the theme this year was Vaishvik Hindi or Bharatiya Sanskriti. So you have to choose the correct answer out of these. So as I have told you that here only the questions will be shared, the answers will be shared with the students who will subscribe to our series. And already we have a lot of students which have subscribed to our series, and you can also subscribe. So let's see what's the second question. Second question is, consider the following statements about Bombay Natural History Society. First, it is part of BirdLife International India. Second, it has been designated as scientific and industrial research organization by Department of Science and Technology. So we have to choose here also the correct statements. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following statements about Chilka Lake. First, it is the largest lagoon in the world. Second, it is the largest wintering ground for waterfowl. Third, it was first to be declared Ramsar site in India. So you have to choose which of the above statements is correct. So you can pause and can choose the correct option. Let's move on to the fourth question. Fourth question is, which of the tech giants recently released project Navlekha? A. Samsung, B. Apple, C. Facebook, D. Google. So these are the options. You have to tell which of the following has started the project Navlekha. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following statements about Pingli Venkaya. First, he was the designer of Indian national tricolor. Second, he also participated in Indian freedom struggle. So which of the above statements is correct? So we have to choose the correct statement. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements regarding Anganwadi centers. First, they are running as a part of integrated child development program. Second is, a total of 4 services are provided by these centers at rural and urban levels. So you have to choose the correct statement. Friends, before moving to next question, let me tell you that we, in these current affair test as well as static test, we are covering your whole 12 month previous year current affairs. So this test number 3 is of August current affairs. So we have properly made proper plan so that you people can prepare your syllabus as much as possible. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following got India's first all women SWAT team, special weapons and tactics team? A. Punjab, B. Delhi, C. Kerala, D. Maharashtra. So let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following acts. First, Sexual Harassment Act 2013. Second, Muslim Women Act 2018. And third is Indecent Representation Act 1986. So we have to choose the correct answer that which of the following have the bearing on the women's safety. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Sexual Harassment of Women at Workplace Act 2013. First, the act covers even the transportation in its definition of workplace. Second, every employer is required to constitute an internal complaints committee at each office branch irrespective of number of employees working in the branch office. So you have to choose the correct answer. So let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following about Kanya Shri scheme. First, it is a scheme of Telangana government. Second, the scheme has won United Nations Public Services Award last year. So let's move on to the next question. Consider the following statements about Ease of Living Index. First, the index is released by Niti Aayog. Second, in the latest release of the index, Bengaluru emerged as the top performer. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next, we consider the following statement about Global Livability Index. First, it is released by United Nations. Second, index is topped by Melbourne in recent release. So these are the options before you. Let's see what is the next question. You can, friends, pause your video. It is not necessary that you have to follow with the pace that I'm covering. I have to actually cover your lecture as fast as possible. So that's why I'm reading the questions quickly. So you can pause the video. You can think for the answer and then can move forward. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Indian National Trust for Art and Cultural Heritage. First, it is a body functioning under the Ministry history of culture. Second, it enjoys a special consultative status with the UNESCO. And we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let's move to the next question. Next is 14th question. Consider the following statements about Appellate Tribunal for Electricity. First, it is an executive body functioning under the Ministry of Power. Second, it consists of a chairperson and three other members. So you have to choose the correct answer. So options are one only, B, second only, both one and two and none. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about the recent regulations issued by the Food Security and Safety Standards of Food Safety and Standards Authority of India in relation to honey. So the maximum sucrose content in honey is fixed at 10%. Second, the maximum proportion of Serbia callosa and honeydew is fixed at 15%. So you have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. And let's move to the next question. Next is National Commission for Backward Classes is an A, statutory body. Second, constitutional body. C, executive body. D, NGO. So here you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is consider the following statements regarding restricted area permit regime. First, under it, foreign nationals are restricted to visit protected or restricted area unless government is satisfied. Second, they are notified under foreigners order 1963. So which of the above statements is correct? We have to choose that. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about members of parliament local area development scheme. First, the scheme was launched in 2003. Second, the MPs are implementing authority in their respective constituencies. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about concessional financing scheme. First, it aims to support Indian entities bidding for strategically important infrastructure projects abroad. And second is the approval of strategically important projects is done by Ministry of External Affairs. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements regarding Benami Transactions Act 2016. First, the act provides for up to 7 years imprisonment to those indulging in such transactions. Second, the property which is Benami can be confiscated by the government without any compensation. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is which of the following states will have India's first national sports university? A, Haryana. B, Kerala. C, Manipur. D, Maharashtra. So you have to tell the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about Ujjwala Yojana. First, it aims to provide free LPG connections to women falling below poverty line. Second, the implementation of the scheme is done by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. So here you have to choose that which of the above statements is correct with regard to Ujjwala Yojana. Next question is consider the following statements about prompt corrective action. First, it is a plan to help banks come out of stressed asset solution. Second, it is initiated by RBI. We have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. First, it is implemented by Ministry of Housing and Urban Poverty Alleviation. Second, it's the scheme provides subsidized housing loans. Third, the scheme envisages housing for all by 2025. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is the strategic partnership model sometimes seen in news is a model text for establishing future bilateral strategic partnerships. A policy aimed at manufacturing high tech in defense equipment in India by engaging Indian private sector companies. C, a model text for bilateral investment treaty negotiations. D, a policy meant to promote government-to-government defense acquisition deals. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about Ayushman Bharat. First is it aims to cover 10 crore poor vulnerable families, providing a coverage up to rupees 2.5 lakh for secondary and tertiary care hospitalization. Second, it will subsume Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana and Senior Citizen Health Insurance Scheme. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about MA program. First, it focuses on promoting breastfeeding for the newly born child. Second, the program is implemented by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan. First, it is a centrally sponsored scheme. The financing share, second is the financing share among central and states is 70:30. So you have to here also choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is recently in news. SmartNet is an initiative of Union Government to A, support the development of cities across India. B, facilitate the connection of small renewable energy generating systems. to power grids. C, established last mile broadband connectivity in rural areas. D, promote rapid adoption of various digital payment systems by making them accessible and user friendly. 30th question is, Project Elephant was launched by the government of India in the year 1992 as a centrally sponsored scheme with the objective to, first, to protect the elephants, their habitat and corridors; second, to address issues of human elephant conflict; third, promote the welfare of captive elephants. So here you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the National Dam Safety Authority of India proposed to be established under the Dam Safety Bill 2018 will, first, examine the cause of any major dam failure; second, perform the role of a street dam safety organization in cases where a dam extends over two or more states, or if the dam of one state falls under the territory of another. 32nd question is, the National Crisis Management Committee is chaired by A, Secretary of Home Affairs; B, Minister of Home Affairs; C, Cabinet Secretary; D, Vice Chairman; Niti EO. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about the Man and Biosphere Council, also known as the International Coordinating Council of the Man and Biosphere Program. So, first, not all members that have biosphere reserves as designated by UNESCO are members of this council. Second, its sessions are normally biennial, that is, held every 2 years. Third is, some UN agencies and IUCN are represented at its sessions as observers. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which nations of the following list comprising of members of SAARC are also members of Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation? First, Bangladesh; second, Bhutan; third, Nepal; fourth, Sri Lanka; fifth, Maldives. So here also you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following statements recently which of the following states recently launched Biju Swasthya Kalyan Yojana? A, Uttar Pradesh; B, Madhya Pradesh; C, Odisha; D, West Bengal. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following months will be separated as Poshan Maah every year? A, August; B, September; C, July; D, November. Next is, which one of the following is not designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site and is also not on the UNESCO World Network of Man and Biosphere Reserves? A, Sundarbans; B, Kanchenjunga; C, Nanda Devi; D, Manas. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which one of the following countries has the smallest coastline opening out to the Caspian Sea? A, Azerbaijan; B, Kazakhstan; C, Turkmenistan; D, Iran. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Umang app. First, the app of the aim of the application is to promote mobile governance in India. Second, the app is developed by Department of Science and Technology. So we have to choose the correct answer. So here also you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements with reference to the Defense India Startup Challenge. First, it is part of IDEX scheme. Second is, the purpose is to promote defense innovation and to make India self-reliant in defense technology. So here also you have to choose the correct statement. And let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Niryat Mitra mobile app. First, the app has been developed by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. Second, the purpose of app is to provide valuable information to individuals planning to enter international trade. So here we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about CERTAIN. First, it is a government mandated agency to protect country's information and technology infrastructure. Second, the organization is responsible for the administration of IT Act 2008. Third, according to the recent report, India faced highest number of cyber attacks from US. So here you have to choose the correct statement. Let's move to the next question. Next question. Next is, consider the following statements about National Disaster Response Force. First, the force enjoys statutory status under the Disaster Management Act 2005. Second, recently government has approved raising for additional battalions of the force to reduce response time to any disaster. So here also you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Red Plus initiative. First, it is a mechanism developed by parties to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Second, the main purpose of the mechanism is to reduce emission of greenhouse gases by sustainable forest management. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, National Tiger Conservation Authority is an A, it is an executive body attached to Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change; B, statutory body; C, constitutional body; D, a society registered under the Societies Registration Act 1860. This is the question. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Korba Tiger Reserve. First, it is India's oldest national park. Second, it was also the first place where Project Tiger was launched in 1973. Third, it has also been declared important bird area by Wildlife International. So here you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Nauredi Sanctuary was seen in news recently. To which state it belongs? A, Maharashtra; B, Manipur; C, Mizoram; D, Madhya Pradesh. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Petco. First, India is the world's largest consumer of it. Second, it emits 50% more greenhouse gases than coal. So here also you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Bhitarkanika National Park is in which state? A, Odisha; B, West Bengal; C, Andhra Pradesh, the Tamil Nadu. So let's move on to the next question. Next is recently RUCO, that is reusing used cooking oil initiative, was launched by which authority? A. Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. D. Ministry of Urban Affairs. C. Ministry of National Highways and Road Transportation. D. Ministry of Women and Child Development. Let's move on to the next question. Next is total polar compounds help in A. curbing pollution. B. measuring the quality of cooking oil. C. a compound for decomposing inorganic solid waste. B. Eliminating chronic diseases like Alzheimer's disease, extra. So let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about the Compensatory Afforestation Fund Act. First, it is an act that provides for creation of a fund where compensatory amount in relation to deforestation under a project is to be deposited. Second, the fund is available for undertaking any green activity. So here we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following biosphere reserves was included in World Network of Biosphere Reserves recently? A. Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. B. Kanchenjunga Biosphere Reserve. C. Panchmani Biosphere Reserve. D. Sundarban Biosphere Reserve. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Spitzer telescope belongs to which of the following space agencies? A. European Space Agency. B. ISRO. C. Russian Space Agency. And D. is NASA. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Horizon 2020. First, it is the European Union Research and Innovation Program. Second, the program is open only to member states of the European Union. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Large Hadron Collider is a particle accelerator installed on which continent? A. North America. B. Europe. C. Asia. D. Australia. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following statements about Euler satellite is incorrect? A. It will measure winds around the globe and help improve weather forecasting. B. The satellite has been launched by NASA. C. It is launched into polar orbit. D. All are correct. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Bureau of Indian Standards. First, it is an executive body working under the Ministry of Common Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. Second, Minister in charge of Ministry acts as the ex officio president of the Bureau of Indian Standards. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about InSight's mission of NASA. First, it will study the interior planet of Mars. Second, it will help in enhancing our understanding about the evolution of rocky planets. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, New Horizon is a European Space Agency's program to map the surfaces of Pluto, including its atmosphere. Second, it recently sent back data suggesting that there could be an oxygen wall at the end of the our solar system. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following cities will have India's first genetic bank for wildlife conservation? A. Chennai. B. Bengaluru. C. Kolkata. D. Hyderabad. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about conservation of endangered species laboratory. First, it is India's only research facility engaged in conservation and preservation of wildlife. Second, it is based in Kolkata. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Assam shares its borders with which of the following states countries? First, Sikkim. Second, Myanmar. Third, Tripura. Fourth, Meghalaya. Fifth, Bhutan. So here you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, with reference to Indian economy, public sector enterprises are designated with different status. Which of the following public sector enterprises are Maharatna? First, Steel Authority of India. Second, Bharat Electronics Limited. Third, GAIL Limited. Fourth, Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited. So here we have to choose that which of the following is your Maharatna. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following industries requires an industrial license to start business in India? First, tobacco and cigar products. Second, electronic, aerospace and defense equipment. Third, hazardous chemicals. Fourth, alcoholic drinks. So here you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, United Nations Military Observer Group in India, India and Pakistan mainly. A. monitors the ceasefire in the disputed Jammu and Kashmir. B. enforces the Karachi Agreement between India and Pakistan. C. submits analytical reports of the Sachin region. D. looks after the refugees and illegal immigrants from both sides of the border. So here you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Banks Board Bureau. First, it was set up in February 2016 as an autonomous body based on the recommendations of RBI appointed NAI committee to improve the governance of public sector banks. Second, it guides banks on mergers and consolidations and governance issues to address bad loans problem, among other issues. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following are the major changes in taxation sharing mechanism between union and your state governments after the goods and services tax reforms. First, Goods and Services Tax Council is a constitutional body for making recommendations to the union and state government on issues related to goods and services tax. Second, states have no power to impose and appropriate any kind of indirect taxes. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, which one of the following releases biennial environmental performance index report? First, A, Yale University, Columbia University in collaboration with World Economic Forum, B, Cornell University and NC, the World Health Organization, C, Institute for Health Metrics and Evaluation of Work, World Bank, D, United Nations Environment Program. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about transiting exoplanet survey satellite. First, it is NASA's mission to look for planets orbiting the brightest stars in the Earth sky. Second, it is sent into an orbit around Earth which is never used before. So here you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, the GI tag recently unveiled by government is incredible, India's treasures. Second is, Karnataka is the state with highest number of GI products. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, oxytocin hormone plays an important role in reproduction, childbirth and lactation. Second, oxytocin is used to increase the size of vegetables such as pumpkins. Third, recently Ministry of Health and Family Welfare banned the import of oxytocin and its formulation. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following statements with reference to the international North-South transport corridor. First, India, Iran, Azerbaijan, Russia are its founder members. Second, the corridor connects the Indian Ocean and Persian Gulf, the Caspian Sea via Iran, then connects Northern Europe via Russia. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, with reference to the Indian Ocean Rim Association, consider the following statements. First, the IORA is a regional forum bringing together representatives of government, business and academia for promoting cooperation and closer interaction among them. Second, Singapore is the latest member to join IORA. Third, 2017 Indian Ocean Rim Association Summit was the first IORA summit. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements with reference to Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. First, it aims to boost the rural connectivity in hitherto unconnected rural habitations. Second, the population criteria is followed to identify the habitations that are to be provided road connectivity. Third, scheme is implemented by Ministry of Rural Development. Let's move to the next question. Next is, recently SAARC Agri Cooperative Business Forum was held in which capital? A, New Delhi, B, Dhaka, C, Kathmandu, D, Islamabad. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Small Farmers Agri Business Consortium in India. First, SFAC is constituted as a society to facilitate agri business ventures by catalyzing private investment. And second is, it implements National Agriculture Market ENAM electronic trading platform. So you have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let's move on to the next statement. Next question. Next question is, with reference to the National Policy on Biofuels 2018, which was recently approved by the Cabinet, consider the following statements. First, with a thrust on advanced biofuels, the policy indicates a viability gap funding scheme for 2G ethanol bio refineries in addition to additional incentives, tax incentives, higher purchase price as compared to first generation biofuels. Next is, second, the policy encourages setting up of supply chain mechanisms for biodiesel production from non-edible oil seeds, used cooking oil and short gestation crops. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about participatory notes. First, the holder of these notes must be necessarily registered in FII in India as FII in India, that is foreign institutional investor. Second is, the notes are infamous for their role in money laundering in India. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about zero budget natural farming. First, it is method of farming where the cost of growing and harvesting plants is zero. Second, the practice involves zero uses of chemical fertilizers and pesticides. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about long-term irrigation fund. First, it is a dedicated fund created under NABARD to finance incomplete major and medium irrigation projects. Second, the corpus of the fund is 40,000 crore. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, recently in news, iCraft is related to A, literature, B, food processing, C, disaster risk reduction, D, data protection framework. Next question is, consider the following statements about regional comprehensive economic partnership. First, it is a partnership proposed between ASEAN nations, including six other nations with which ASEAN has free trade agreement. Second is the other six nations are India, China, South Korea, Japan, Australia, and New Zealand. So you have to choose the correct statement. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about United Nations Environment Programme. First, it was founded in 1972 as a result of Stockholm Conference. Second, it is headquartered in Gigiri, Nairobi. Third, it coordinates the environmental activities of United Nations, including funding of environmental-related development projects. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, recently the fourth edition of Asian Electoral Stakeholders Forum was held recently in which country? A. India, B. Bangladesh, C. China, D. Sri Lanka. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Asia Pacific Institute for Broadcasting Development. First, it is established in 1965 under United Nations. Second, it is headquartered in Kuala Lumpur. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, the Sathi initiative will promote the use of energy efficient equipment in A. the textile industry, B. irrigation, C. banking industry, D. petroleum refining sector. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, Project Elephant was launched by the Government of India in the year 1992 as a centrally sponsored scheme with objectives to, first, to protect elephants, their habitats and corridors, second, to address issues of human and elephant conflict, third, promote the welfare of captive elephants. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, the pitch to move competition recently in the news is related to which one of the following summits? So A. Global Entrepreneurship Summit, B. Global Wind Summit, C. Global Mobility Summit, D. United Nations Wildlife Summit. Let's move to the next question. Next is, E. Aksharayan was recently launched by A. Ministry of Information Technology, B. Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, C. Ministry of Home Affairs, and your Ministry of Human Resource Development. And next is, OSmart is an umbrella scheme recently approved for implementation by the Union Cabinet. It will help address issues directly linked related to, first, Sustainable Development Goal 11, SDG 12, SDG 13, SDG 14. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Parliament recently passed the 123rd Constitutional Amendment Bill. Till now, the National Commission for Backward Classes could only A. recommend inclusion and exclusion of caste from the OBC list, second, recommend the level of income that cutoffs of the creamy layer from the benefits of reservation for the OBCs, third, investigate all matters relating to constitutional and other legal safeguards of the OBCs. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Exercise Peace Mission is a multi-nation counter-terror exercise that takes place under the framework of A. BRICS, B. Warsaw Pact, C. SCO, D. SARC. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, letter of undertaking and letters of credit have recently been in the news in the context of affairs related to A. imports and exports, B. credit guarantees for MSMEs, C. non-performing assets in non-banking financial companies, D. E-NAM. So this is about your 95th question. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the Global Peace Index, the 12th edition of which was released recently, is produced by A. International Stockholm Peace Research Institute, B. Institute for Economics and Peace, C. International Peace and Development Initiative, D. UNESCO. And let's move to the next question. Next is, under the price support scheme, the procurement of which of the following crops is undertaken? First, copras, second, groundnut, third, pulses, and fourth, cotton and tobacco. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about Sinai Peninsula. First, it is a raindrop shaped peninsula. Second, it links Asia with Africa. Third is, it adjoins Israel and Gaza Strip on the east. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, under the Foreigners Restricted Areas Order 1963, which of the following areas have been declared as restricted areas? First, parts of the state of Sikkim, second, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, third, Lakshadweep. So you have to choose the correct answer. The last question of the day is, which one of the following countries has the smallest coastline opening out to the Caspian Sea? So this, I think, question, I think it has been repeated. A. Azerbaijan, B. Kazakhstan, C. Turkmenistan, and D. Iran. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture and today's questions. And your next test will be tomorrow, and that test also will be of current affair. And if in case you want to join our test series, you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveis21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at this number, that is 8968426481. So this is our official number linked with the channel. So in case you wish to join our test series and also wish to get the solutions of the test, then you can subscribe to our initiative. So thank you, friends. Details will be mentioned when you will contact us. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day. Thank you very much.